faith, grace. It's the most powerful influences in the universe. Through the atonement of Christ, the message of the gospel can take sinners and turn them into saints. I've seen the gospel take homosexuals and make them straight. Drunkards become sober. Liars become honest. Life-changing. That's the gospel. There's this false atonement. Jesus saves you in your sin. The Bible says he saves you from your sin. There's a false sanctification. They say, oh, sanctification is a lifelong process. Somebody tells you that. Somebody tells me that. I know they got sin in their life. Mm-hmm. Sanctification is a lifelong process? Sounds like impenitence to me. Sounds like you got something in your life. You're like, I'm just going to deal with this for the rest of my life. I'm just going to hold on to this, whatever it is. No, sanctification is a lifelong process. The Bible says you're either sanctified or you're unsanctified. There's no middle ground. It's like a light switch. You're on or you're off. You're sanctified or you're unsanctified. There's no middle ground. You're dedicated to God or you're not. You're consecrated to God or you're not. You're dedicated to God or dedicated to the devil. Dedicated to sin or dedicated to righteousness. Which is it? Can you serve two masters? Oh, it's a lifelong process to decide which master you're going to serve. No, you it's instantaneous. It's instant. Sanctification can happen in an instant. Now, you can be sanctified one day and unsanctified another day. You can be sanctified 1 hour and unsanctified another hour. You could backslide into sin. You could repent of your sin. The righteous can become wicked. The wicked can become righteous. That's free will. But you can't be both at the same time. You can't be righteous and wicked. You can't be sanctified and unsanctified. You can't be holy and unholy. You can't serve God and serve the devil at the same time. Now, maturity is a lifelong process. Knowledge is a lifelong process. But obedience isn't. A new convert is just as obedient in heart to the knowledge that he has as a mature believer who's been serving the Lord for decades, as an elder in the church, just as obedient as that man. They just differ in their degree of knowledge. So maturity is a lifelong process. Knowledge is a lifelong process. But obedience isn't. You're obeying God or you're not. So the Bible, true Christianity is a holy thing. The Bible calls Christians saints. You obey God daily. Holiness is your habit. We need people, like I said, they preach radical depravity, they call it. Radical depravity. Always talk about how sinful everybody is. We need radical holiness. But how to overcome the sin. Death to sin. You know, they say, well, you're going to sin every day of your life until you die. You're going to sin every day until you die. How can you go on living if you believe that? Yeah, amen. I'd be like, take me now, Lord. I'm done with this. I am so done with sin. I don't want to live another day in this. I can't live another day in sin. You can't stop sinning until you die. I'm ready to die. Done with this. Forget it. I'm checking out. I don't know how they keep on living if they believe that. They must not hate their sin like they ought to. Yeah. If they think, I'm just going to do this till I die. Yeah. How could you live? How could you live like that? So you're going to sin until you die. So death is your savior? Death is going to save you? That's a false savior. That's another Christ. That's another Jesus. That's not the Jesus of the Bible. He shall save his people from their sin. Grace teaches us to live righteously and godly in this present world. The Bible says, let him that is righteous be righteous still. Let him that is filthy be filthy still. Hey, death doesn't change your character. However you die is how you will be for eternity. If you die righteous, you'll live righteous for eternity. If you die sinful, you'll be a sinner for eternity. Amen. The Bible says, let the righteous be righteous still. Let the filthy be filthy still. That's how it works. You take into eternity whatever character you die with. And that's why you must be born again in this life.